Hey, welcome back to Palm Breeze Cafe. Kim.
Hey, Lee, how's it going,
man? It's going quite well. In fact, I noticed a couple weeks ago you got hooked on a site. You're looking for a puppy.
Our dog, sadly, we've had her for over 10 years and she passed away, natural causes. But I'm looking to get a new dog.
And next week just happens to be Animal Shelter Awareness.
I know, that's awesome. So it's perfect timing.
Good timing. And I've been looking for a dog for year and a half.
Yeah. Really hard, you're looking. I know, it's a big commitment.
It's a lot of work.
You're bringing another member to the family. And very often,
parents will get a dog for the kids, and the kids are saying, oh, this is nice. You take care of it.
Right, exactly.
So it's a lot of responsibility.
Yeah, a lot of responsibility, and you want to be careful. And it's a good thing to be able to support things like animal shelters so that you can rescue those dogs that may not have an opportunity to go to a good home.
Yeah,
so
that's pretty good.
It's a good thing.
And we've got some educational stuff, too.
Right.
Lee Colbert's got a really cool little site. I don't know how you find this stuff.
I've got nothing else to do.
Okay. You make very good use of your time because you get
stuff. Well, I do have a good site. It has nothing to do with animals, although certainly it could have everything to do with animals, depending on what you do with the site. But if you ever find yourself in a sticky situation and you need post-its, you're putting post-its all over the place, well, this site is for you because it allows you to put post-its on a virtual wall. It's very cool, very organized, and very easy to use. So I'm looking forward to showing you that.
Yeah, that was a lot of fun. I was playing with that a lot. And Kim, what are you going to be doing here?
Oh, I'm doing something that's really exciting. We get to finally talk about a product that you and I have been on experimenting with for about a year now.
Mm-hmm.
But we've been under privacy restrictions because it hadn't been announced. But we're going to be talking about Project Roam from Adobe. It's an incredibly cool.
And you're going to tie
I've
that
never
right
seen
in
anything like this.
With the animal
and I'm going to
shelters.
Make a flyer for. I'm going to make a flyer in Adobe Roam, and I'm going to show you how to. Post that in different locations, printed or on the web, from one document.
Since you've got Peggy Adams on there, I wonder if we can give that to her when we're done.
All right, I'd be happy to.
That would be really nice.
Yeah, sure.
And Frank's got a few things happening over there, too.
Oh, excuse me. I was on PetFinder.com here. I was looking for a dog.
Looking for a new dog, too?
Yeah.
You need another mouth to feed in your household.
Yeah, I need another one, right, exactly. But, you know, it's nice having a pet, right? We
Absolutely.
All love pets, you know, and it's great for especially kids to grow up with a pet. I mean, that's, you know, they a lot of kids need that interaction. Well, sometimes you can't have a pet in your house, but you can have a virtual pet.
Ooh.
And we all learn from our pets. I got a few apps I want to show you how we can learn from our virtual pets.
And we're going to be introducing some iPad apps. We're going to start looking at iPad apps this week, and we'll kind of work that into the show as part of an extension of
Yeah, thank you, because
Cafe.
All three are on the iPad.
Oh, great. Awesome.
That's good. And I'm going to be doing something on Animal Shelter Awareness Week and talking about a lot of the sites that are out there that deal with the Humane Society, all
awesome.
The different groups that help take care of animals that are definitely in need of help.
That's fun. And I'm sure you have lots of interesting news.
I've got some news here. I got
okay.
good threads going here.
All right.
First thing, and this isn't really that recent news, but it's building tremendously. We've got Barnes & Noble with the Nook. Now, this is an e-reader, sort of like the Kindle and Amazon.
It's another handheld.
Yeah, except it's color.
Ah.
And it's really nice. Here's
you mean the case is in color or the screen
shows colors?
No,
the screen's in color. Here's a little piece of it right there, a little article about it. And I noticed Courtney zoomed in on that. Notice it's only $250.
Right.
Ouch!
Only, right.
That one hurts. But it's awesome here. I'm going to switch to this other screen here. And this is a video on YouTube. But there gives you an idea of what's on it. You can do full-color magazines. And I'll just move ahead a little bit. Oh, this is cool. Magazines can have embedded videos in them.
Really?
So, you know, you've got this. And
the geek in me wants to know what format they're publishing in, but
yeah.
I guess we'll figure that out as we go along.
So, yeah, over here, they'll show some more. And another thing that they're really talking about a lot, let's see if I can find the spot. Here, right there you go, for kids.
To me button.
It'll read
and listen
to you.
The story being read
it's interactive. They're doing that with a lot of children's books.
Oh, wow, they've got animations on. They're simple animations, but I mean,
magazines
you know.
Also come to life in a new way on Nook subscription. Or you can just buy a single.
So then, so this is Barnes & Noble? Barnes & Noble. So they probably have tie-ins with the publishers, so you can get discounted subscriptions.
You know what? We were looking
kind of
at
stuff.
That today, and mm-hmm. the discounts on subscriptions are not that great yet.
Uh-huh. Okay.
And I really think that's going to be an important part for them. If they can't give you at least 50% off the shelf price.
Well, and you know, this, and this falls in the middle. You have the Kindle from Amazon that costs, I think they're about $120 now.
Or $180 or something like that.
Maybe, and then now you've got the iPad at the $500 starting point.
Ouch.
So this one's in the middle and may
fit
for some
people.
Oh, by the
way, this has a browser and it's 3G enabled.
Really?
And it's capable of doing Wi-Fi too.
Wow.
And they even put in the ad that all the Barnes & Noble stores have free Wi-Fi. So it's a nice deal.
So you go to the bookstore to read a book on a device.
Well, you're going to buy it from them anyway.
I like to go to the bookstore to read a book.
They've got Starbucks there.
Oh, okay.
Okay. Hey, how many of your friends ever used LimeWire? Remember LimeWire?
Yeah.
Guess what? It just got shut down by the federal courts.
Oops.
Yeah, a lot of copyright infringement there. They had a...
And LimeWire was a file sharing service, software that basically was used for
music
and movie downloads.
Yeah, in fact, the music industry is seeking a mere $450 million.
That always amazed me.
From every parent who allowed their child to download stuff using LimeWire.
But, but LimeWire itself was the application. I never understood really, you know, it was for file sharing.
Yes.
But how people used it was wrong.
Yes.
But
yes.
The actual application wasn't wrong.
No, there's nothing wrong there. It was just meant to build large, large data. The idea being, and this is kind of called a BitTorrent.
That's a Nutella.
Okay. So there's, but it doesn't use the same technology where you have these files stored on multiple computers and it just grabs them from whichever one is idle to make things go faster.
Or you can choose where it's from based on the business.
So why are they going after the service that provides the application, not the users?
Well, because the way they set up their infrastructure, anyone could upload anything they wanted, and so you
had... There was no security.
Immediately, people burning their disks, their CDs, and putting them up for their friends to have. And once they're up, their friends become everybody. So
We've looked at Androids and things like that before. This one is so real looking. Look at this. This is called Actroid. And the picture, the still picture there looks pretty good. But I'm going to scroll down real quick here. Courtney got a close-up there. Let me scroll down and see if I can keep the movie right in there. Watch how real the action is in this. The thing is amazing. Marion's first comment was, will it cook and clean house for me?
I was just going to ask you, how much does it cost to get a woman that does...
look how real the expressions are. The expression on this is so good.
Oh, they're facial expressions.
Yeah, it's really amazing.
That's pretty realistic.
So they're doing a lot of really cool stuff with this. I got our timer here going, so we're going to move on to the next story.
That's the future of television news right there.
This British student invented a solar-powered refrigerator.
Your other one's still making noise.
Oh, yeah, it is. Okay, just add water to this, and it works out in Africa. Whoops, wrong one there. Let me go back there and kill that other video. Forgot to do that. Anyway, it's very simple, and they're using this in Africa. It goes down
Invented by a student.
Yeah, invented by a college student over in England. And it'll actually go down to a very cool refrigeration level so they can store meat and dairy products and things like
amazing,
that. Huh? Hey, the gingerbread man, did you see that last week?
No.
It's a Google thing, and they got a big gingerbread man in the courtyard. It's the code name for the upcoming version of Android.
Ah.
So that's
they
cool.
They always name it after food.
I guess it's not a code
their
name
Android,
anymore.
Their Android releases are always named. Their last one was frozen yogurt, Froyo. And this one's gingerbread.
Okay, real quickly here.
Telling you, it's true.
Okay, Android acquisition. Google says best deal ever. They're guessing about $50 million, but guess what? Oracle is saying that they stole every bit of it.
Well, they'll work that out, and you'll come back in just a moment, and we've got some great stuff for you here at Palm Breeze Cafe, all about animals and good things.
See you in a minute.